What is going on, guys? It is Bucky, and welcome to your 10th C++ tutorial. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to create a function that uses parameters. Now, a parameter is quite simply additional information that that function needs in order to work. So, let me give you guys a quick example of this. Say you made a function to calculate the age of someone, how old they were. Well, some additional information you would need before you can calculate that is, what year were they born? And once you have this information, you can calculate their age. So let's go ahead and, now that we understand why a function would need additional information, let's go ahead and create a simple simple function to use additional information. So let's go ahead and create a function that just prints out Bucky's favorite number is blank. We might say Bucky's favorite number is 20, Bucky's favorite number is 68, Bucky's favorite number is 99. Well, since we don't know what my favorite number is yet, we're just going to go ahead and put a variable in place for that number. So since this isn't going to be making any calculations really, we can just go ahead and use void, because that means return nothing. So name your function anything you want. I'm just going to name mine print crap, since that's all it's going to do, print crap out on the screen. And before, we just added these empty parentheses with nothing in between them, and then we coded the body right here. Well, whenever we use a parameter, you actually put that information right in your parentheses. And check this out. You know how I said we didn't know what that number is yet? And that's the additional information that we need. Well, since we don't know what it is yet, we just go ahead and we set it equal to a variable. And since this is an integer, we go ahead and see it equal to the variable int x. You can name your variable anything you want, but I'm going to name mine x because it's really simple, easy to work with. So now, we can go ahead and we can add the body of this function. And all we're going to do in this function is print out on the screen, Bucky's favorite number is, did I spell everything wrong? Yep, good to go. Bucky's favorite number is X. And then just go ahead and end that line. And now when our function runs, it's going to run something like this. If we say that our favorite number is 20, it's going to say Bucky's favorite number is 20. If we say that our favorite number is 10, Bucky's favorite number is 10. So we can run this function a bunch of times and give it a different piece of information each time, and it's going to work. So let's go ahead and remember, in order to use a function in your main, you just go ahead and you type the function name, and then you add your parentheses and your semicolon at the end. But whenever your function needs an additional piece of information, you need to give it that information inside the parentheses. So we know from making our function that it needs one integer in order to work. So let's go ahead and inside these parentheses, give it one integer, 20. So now what it's going to do is, well, let me go ahead and run this and show it to you guys. Bucky's favorite number is 20. All right. So what happened is this. We said, alright, C++ program, we want to use this print crap method. Well, it said, alright, in order to use this method, I'm going to need one integer. So we gave it the integer 20. So then, whenever in this function it came across the variable x, it just substituted 20 for that. So whenever you're making parameters, you first need to list what type of data and also a variable name. So then, whenever we give it that variable, it substitutes that variable for x later on in the program. So for example, let's give it one more example, like 854. Well, now we run it and it says Bucky's favorite number is 854. And that's the beauty of parameters and functions. It doesn't need to be the same every time, so that's why you can use variables. So again, what we did is we created a function and it needed an additional piece of information, which was an integer. And since it didn't know the value yet, it just went ahead and it set it equal to a variable. Then later on in the body, whenever it came across that variable, it knew whatever value you told it to substitute for x, that's what value is substituted for x. So we can run this 100 times with 100 different values if we want. It's going to substitute it for x each time and use that information to plug it in. So that's the basics of how you use functions with parameter. Again, whenever you're creating a parameter, use the data type and a variable name, and whenever you're using the function, don't forget to pass in or give it whatever information it needs. So that's pretty cool, simple enough, we understand that. But in the next tutorial, what I'm going to be teaching you guys is how to use functions that use multiple parameters. What if a function needs more than one piece of information in order to work? Well, I'm going to show you guys how to do that too, and it's a little different than this, so you definitely want to watch that. So once you understand this and understand the basics behind functions and parameters, you're ready to move on to the next tutorial. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.